Hey YouTubers, and welcome back to another DVD and Blu-ray update. I think it's been 3 weeks I made my last video. Let's go on to the DVDs. First one I got from the pawn shop here and where I live. It's Green Fingers with Clive Owen and Helen Mirren. About, I think, a convict who gets free and on, but he is still on probation, so he enters a competition where they're going to landscape for prizes, and he joins the team with other convicts under supervision from Helen Mirren. Helen Mirren's character, I think so, but it was kind of blind bias. It looks like a fun movie, gets some okay ratings, and I got it for €1. Next movie is the first movie from the guys from Broken Lizard, who made the Super Troopers. And I haven't seen this movie yet, but heard of it, but it wasn't released in Europe, I think, because I need to get the Region 1 version. And it's Puddle Cruiser. It was used, said it wasn't a very good edition, but the disc was loose and the disc was kind of smudged, so I sent my information back, but I have to check it out. If it works okay, then I'm not going to make more work of it, but I hate it. But I like those Super Troopers. I heard they were going to work on the second one. I really enjoy those Broken Lizard movies. It's maybe not everyone's cup of tea, but I really enjoyed it. So curious to see how this one is. Next one is a movie with Joseph Gordon-Levitt, Emil Dravin, and probably if you hear those the names combined, you know which movie I'm talking about. It's Brick. The movie is directed by Rian Johnson, who also made Looper and the Brothers Bloom. But this one, I think it was released in 2006, I saw it in the cinemas, and I really enjoyed it. It is a great detective kind of film noir atmosphere to it. I thought it was really great. I really liked the atmosphere in it, also because it's also one part very serious, but also there's some light humor in it. But I really liked the style and the atmosphere and... a great film. The next one is a blind buy. I heard a lot about it, but I have never seen the movie. So yeah, a lot of blind buys, but also for €1. It's Itchy the Killer. And I heard that this movie is pretty sick, so I'm very curious how that is. If I have to skip a dinner to watch this, because otherwise I'll throw it up all over the floor here. Then I will skip it, but skip dinner. Next one is a movie from Carl Reiner. Didn't know what it was from him. I only know about this movie is because I saw it in the 90s. It was a lot of fun during that time. I watched a lot of those 80s comedies, and I recently thought of it and wanted to get it, but it's also a movie that didn't get a European release, so I bought it for a few euros via play.com. It's Summer School with Mark Harmon, where most people watch NCIS knows who he is. He's the lead character there. He's the lead actor there. It's been a while that I've seen it. I think he's a gym teacher, a very bad gym teacher. They decide that he's going to teach summer school. Next ones are Blu-rays. First one is Excision. I heard about this movie via a trailer I've got from via my brother. He sent me a trailer of Suburban Gothic with the nerd guy from Criminal Minds. It looks like a lot of fun, and then I saw that the director first made this movie based on a short he made, I think, what I saw. And it's about a bully teenager who escapes via vivid fantasies. So she's very daydreaming, and that's all. I think I know, but the trailer looks very well, and looks like a fun movie, so I'm curious how it is. So if you see this movie, please leave a comment. Next is a season of a show that I still need to watch, and when you see it, you say, oh, you're one of those guys who tells me at work don't spoil about it because you haven't seen it yet, and but we're now in season 5, or almost in season 5. Maybe you can guess which series I'm talking about. It's Game of Thrones season 3. Yes, I still need to watch it. I am current also only in the third season of Walking Dead, but I'm barely hooked, and this looks like also fun. And bought these because of the Media Markt where I live. They have a pretty good deals on most of the times on Game of Thrones, but because I think you still pay what I saw, €40, 5 disc set with 10 episodes and a lot of extras and very cool slipcover, and the case where it's in. Let's see. It gets off when there are the five discs in. And they had a pretty good deal for these. There were two seasons for the price of 35 euros. So if you bought two if you bought two series, you pay 35 euros. So I actually paid 17 euros and 50 cents. I think it's about $20. It's very cheap for this big as box set. It's very awesome. And yes, I will start watching it as soon as I can. And I'm glad that these days when I used to watch series, I was happy when they got about 24 episodes. And today I'm happy that there are a lot of shows who only have 12 or 10 episodes, because then you can watch more and different series and rewatch them far more than you actually can. Because there are a lot of series, you have 25 episodes, say 7 seasons. It's not very likely that you're going to rewatch it a lot of times. So I'm glad with those new shows. There are a lot of, there are only about 12 episodes. So that's very nice. True Detective. Haven't seen yet. Also a small series. Heard a lot of good things about 8 episodes. And I heard good things about it. So this was, and for Game of Thrones, I understand that there was a little, a big price drop, but this is wasn't released that long ago. So when this was released, you pay about 38 euros for it, and now I paid 70 euro 50 for it. So the next movie is kind of a funny story. I posted also on my Instagram a while back. It's a movie starring Sam Raimi. It's based on a short Sam Raimi and Bruce Campbell made when they were younger. It's Thou Shall Not Kill Except, also known as Strikes War, but Strikes War is the original title of the 8mm short movie where this movie is based on. It's directed by George Becker and produced by Scott Spiegel, and those names sound familiar because I haven't read as much as well when I was on holiday, but I'm reading that book from Bruce Campbell, When Chins Kill, or something called that, and I recognize a lot of names, and they wrote in the book they were making short movies, and so that was kind of fun to see that actually the one of those short movies they made is put as an extra on this film. And but the other really funny story for me personally, a nephew of mine who is a jazz pianist, he was in a movie in 1980, in a movie called The Bende van Hiernaast, The Gang from Next Door. In the time they really had casting agency, so they went to schools and they're looking for actors who can play instruments. And my nephew, he can play piano, so he was cast for that. But somebody at IMDb, and I'm not quite sure, also gave credits that he was in Strikers War, in this movie, as George Crazy. I'm not quite sure how, because my nephew only did one movie in 1980. So who credited him for this 1985 movie? I have no clue, because it's not like he's a very famous actor. He did one movie. So who put him in this movie? So that's... It's weird, but this one looks like a fun, cheesy flick about the guy who comes back from war and notices that something happened to his family or something, and then he's going to take revenge on the gang. And I think Sam Raimi plays the bad guy here, and it looks like a lot of fun. Next one is a movie also, by the way, that was a Region A film. I posted a video a few weeks ago also that I bought a Region 3 Blu-ray player. So that one I can play off on my Blu-ray player. So released on Region A. And this one is also a Region A movie, also didn't has a release here. But I'm not quite sure if I expected too much of this. But it looks like a fun movie called Knights of Badassism, starring Steve Zahn, Summer Glau, Peter Dinklage, and Ryan Kwanten. LARPers, they play live action role playing games, and because something happens, a real monster comes into their world, or they end up in a real world with dragons, and they have to fight, but this time for real. And it looks like a fun movie. There's also some extras on it, like the San Diego Comic-Con panel, interviews with the cast, and an Summerglow hottie montage. Yeah, that doesn't hurt. And the behind the scenes footage, and I really like those films, like those extras for movies. I really entertain. I'm not expecting much of it, but it looks like a lot of fun. And the last one is a box set with three movies on Blu-ray. It's the Three Flavors Cornetto trilogy with Shaun of the Dead, Hot Fuzz, and The World's End. And I have the first two, Shaun of the Dead and Hot Fuzz, on DVD. But I didn't have this one, The World's End. A very cool, fun movie, but not as quite good as the first two, but still very, very entertaining. Why I bought this one? Because I normally do not upgrade. In this case, this was cheaper. I bought this for €10.40. So it was cheaper than I would buy the Blu-ray separately from The World's End. So because it was about €13, so I thought, now well, in this case it's worth it to upgrade the other ones, and I give the other ones to my brother, so he's also happy then. And also I think the Shaun of the Dead edition that I have of the has no extras on it. It was an extra rental, I think, so I got this one also with got the first two movies in better quality, and the first one also again with the extra. So I don't normally I don't do upgrades. So those were my new DVDs and Blu-rays. I hope you enjoyed. If you've seen any movies, if you have a question, if you want to say random things, or you want to say first, is that still a thing? So thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. This was Vlogmas Now, and out.